I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today for lunch, we're having barbecued hot dogs. And I'll just show you the kind of hot dog I have. I don't know if you've seen these or not, but they are very healthy. They're made with chicken and pork, so they don't have a lot of fat in them. They're kind of a longish style, a little bit longer than the normal that you see in the regular hot dog package. And then with them, I'm going to use Coney rolls. Those are split in such a way that you can lay a cooked hot dog over the top, and you can spread that out a little bit, put it inside, and of course ours is going to be barbecued, meaning that it has a sauce on it. That sauce will go inside, and you can ladle some over it as well. So we'll come back to that at the very end. Let's make our sauce. I have 1 tablespoon of butter melted over here in this skillet. I'm going to turn it on, and I'm going to add some vegetables. We need 1/2 cup of chopped green pepper. So that goes in. I'll just tell you what we're putting in, then I'll take them all over there. We need 1/4 cup of chopped celery, and just do a medium chop on these. I used a white onion. This is 3/4 cup. It was not a whole onion. 3/4 cup chopped onion. So we have these 3 vegetables, which are going to the stove, and we're going to add them to our melted butter, and then just saute them up. That means that they want to get very soft and tender. It will take about 5 minutes. So let me go away and get these sauteed. We'll be back to continue the sauce. I sauteed my 3 vegetables, and you can see that they're nice and colorful still, but kind of transparent. And that's what you want to see when you saute vegetables. Now what we're going to do is mix up our barbecue sauce to go on our hot dogs. First thing I'm adding here is ketchup. And I need 3/4 cup, 3/4 cup. We'll just add that into our sauce right here. And then next I have 1/2 cup water. Next is sugar, just regular granulated sugar. I need 1 1/2 tablespoons. So 1 tablespoon, and this is 1/2 tablespoon of sugar. Lemon juice. And what I have are 2 tablespoons measured out of lemon juice. And then we have white vinegar. And this is 1 1/2 tablespoons. Next we have Worcestershire sauce, and any variety that you like, you'll need 2 teaspoons. 2 teaspoons of Worcestershire sauce. And then my last ingredient is dry mustard. And I need 3/4 of a teaspoon. So I have a 1/2 teaspoon measure and a 1/4 teaspoon measure. 3/4 of a teaspoon there. Let's stir this all together. Now we'll take it to the stove, and we're going to cook it and stir it occasionally for about 10 minutes. And when it gets to that point, we'll be putting our hot dogs in and heating them up, and they'll get glazed with all this nice barbecue sauce. So it's off to the stove, and I'll see you back in a few minutes. My barbecue sauce is done, and I brought it over here to finish up my dish. I've tasted of it for flavor, and it tastes superb. I think you'll really enjoy it. It was just really easy to put together. Didn't take long to cook at all. What we do now is go to our hot dogs, and you can use any kind of hot dog that you like. You could even use cheese filled if you want. You could use smoked sausage. Anything of that sort that goes with a bun will be fine. You're going to take the hot dogs that you want and place them in this sauce, and we'll be going back to the stove to heat those up. Hot dogs are done. You can see I have all this sauce piled up on the top to get them from the top and the bottom. They're sizzling away, so they're all nice and warm. Let's serve them. I'm bringing them over here to where my Coney rolls are. And I'll show you what these are like. If you pull, they will separate at the bottom. They're not cut all the way down through. So I'm going to take a couple of them, separate them, and put sauce in there. Then let's get one hot dog. Put it in there. And then some more sauce, which we will ladle over the top. And don't worry if it runs down the sides. This one, you can eat with a fork. So you got a couple of ways of considering that. I think probably the first way is a little more natural, but you do have to take a knife and cut down to the bottom in order for that to spread open wide enough for you. So I have a few sweet pickle chips. These are bread and butter pickle chips. And also with this, I'm going to serve some interesting potato chips, but they're not really potatoes. Actually, these are some exotic vegetables. Things like there are sweet potatoes, there's taro, there's yucca, there are various things, and they happen to be zesty tomato flavored. These are kind of interesting chips that you might want to try sometime if you're tired of potato chips. So here we have our glass of iced tea, and we have our Coney's, our barbecued hot dogs, if you'd rather refer to it that way, and we have a nice lunch ahead of us.